Hi guys, Christopher here with Bangert. I wanted to make a quick video to go over license administration for Sage 300 Construction and Real Estate, Sage 100 Contractor, and Sage Estimating. As a generality, they're going to be pretty much the same and have the same general workability. We'll take a look at each of them briefly, but for the most part, all of the ideas are the same. So we're going to talk about how to open it, what you can do within it, and then just kind of go back over that as a recap. So first, how do we open it? For all of them, you're going to connect up to the Sage license server. Most often that's going to be the Sage server or the app server is the name, something along those lines. And for Sage 300 construction and real estate, it's guaranteed to be the Sage server. It has to exist on the same server as the company data. So that can help you find it in that case. For Sage 300, you're generally going to find it under Sage Administration. For Sage 100 Contractor, that's usually going to be under either Sage 100 Contractor SQL or Sage 100 Contractor, depending on whether you're looking for the SQL or legacy versions. And for Sage Estimating, you're going to find it under Sage Estimating X, where X is going to be the version number for your environment. So let's take a look at what that looks like. We're going to go ahead and open our Start menu, and we'll find first the Sage Estimating. So we're going to see Sage Estimating, and then our currently installed version is 20.1. We'll click on that to expand it and find License Administration 20.1 here. Let's take a look at what that looks like. It's going to take a moment when it opens up to reach out to the entitlement server and verify the current licenses and everything like that. Often, if it's the first time you're opening it, you won't have the Sage client ID or registration name entered yet. In that case, you could click Edit Registration Information in order to add it, or if you needed to change it for some reason, you could do that there as well. You also can click on Update License Information to force an update if the registration information is already there and correct. Let's go ahead and take a look at how we open up the Sage 300. So we're going to click on the Start menu. We're going to scroll until we find Sage Administration. We'll expand it, and we'll find License Administration. The appearance is going to be a little bit different here, and if you have security turned on, it's going to ask you to log in as a Sage Administrator. That requires the Application Administrator role. So we'll go ahead and log in since we have security turned on. We'll see that in general, it's going to be the same idea. We're going to see the registration information. We can change the registration as necessary, and we can click an update button. We'll talk about the deauthorized server a little bit later. And finally, let's take a quick look at how we open the Sage 100 license administrator. So we're going to go ahead and open the start menu again. We're going to find Sage 100 contractor in the start menu. And if it's SQL, you'll see SQL. If it's the legacy version, it'll just say Sage 100 Contractor. You'll click License Administration. And it's going to look, again, generally the same. Once it loads up, you'll be able to edit the registration information if necessary, or click Update. So if we think about, you know, what would we need to do? We could initial license or relicense by using those edit the registration information or just forcing an update by clicking update license information. Each of them is going to have its own little way of saying edit registration information, but it's all generally the same idea. You can also deauthorize your server. Deauthorizing your server is going to drop your licensing and give it back to kind of the void for another server to pick up. They have to have your registration information in order to pick it up, so it's not just giving it out there for somebody to take. And you're going to generally do this most often when you're decommissioning a server as part of a migration. However, if you were having trouble with your licenses seeming to not be picked up correctly or not be available for some reason, sometimes you can trigger things to work correctly by clicking deauthorize and then clicking update to reauthorize. As a generality, clicking deauthorize is something you should avoid unless you can't use the system at all or you're specifically turning it off. And then for multi-server licensing, which you'll see mentioned in both the Sage 100 and the Sage Estimating License Administrators, let's take a look. You see multi-server licensing here in the Sage 100 License Administrator, and you see multi-server licensing here in the Sage Estimating Administrator. You see allocated uses in the Sage 300. All of these allow you to set your licensing across multiple servers. That's going to be generally really ill-advised. That's almost never something you actually want to do. If you're thinking of trying to have access in multiple locations, we suggest you look into maybe a cloud-hosted virtual machine or hosting your own internet-facing terminal server to have remote connections to your Sage environment. If you need any help with that, or you think that multi-server environment is the right thing for you, reach out to us. Let us know, and we can talk with you and help you decide if that really is the correct solution for your needs. So, to recap, if you need to access license administration, you'll open that on your Sage server, typically going to be the Sage or app server as the name. You can force an update by clicking update. That might gather new or missing licenses that haven't been gathered before. You could also try to force some things by clicking deauthorize and then update. And then finally, multi-server licensing is possible in all three, Sage 100 Contractor, Sage 300 Construction and Real Estate, and Sage Estimating, but it's almost never going to be the correct solution. So it's something that you should reach out to us to discuss before you attempt. Thanks very much for watching.